Hi, this is Pastor Lane, and I'm here at the library, but it looks like I'm in paradise right now. But as you can see the lines there, things will get kind of rough if I yank the table and I throw the whole picture out of context, you know. But I just wanted to give a relaxing view in studying the Word of God in a very serious mode. And the study today will be on Melchizedek. However, probably for the first 10 minutes, because most video websites won't let me have more than 10 minutes, I have to do another 10 minutes to finish up the Bible study. So, oh well. That's the way it goes. Well, anyways, sorry about that. My nose itched. I did shave this morning, but I still got baby face shadow. I get dog for that in the military. Well, anyways, I'm going to give you a syllabus of what we're going to discuss regarding Melchizedek. And it's spelled two ways. In the Old Testament, it's spelled M-E-L-C-H-I-Z-E-D-K-E-K. And then in the New Testament, it's M-E-L C-H-I-S-E-D-E-K. Okay, well, here's the syllabus, or what we're, the outline of what we're going to talk about, roughly. I'm going to walk you to the Bible study, which I already did, tell what version we're going to be using. Eliminate concerns about reading a certain version, which I use the King James, so that you'll have confidence and faith in using it. You can use any one you like, but I really am going to show you some things to ease your mind that you can study that if you want to. The pitfalls of doing Bible study, discussing faith, and how to avoid the pitfalls. That's very important in doing Bible study. And then I'm going to talk about the passages in the Old and New Testament about Melchizedek in the New Testament. And I will briefly go over those. My main focus will be on Hebrews 6:20 through Hebrews 7:4. It really gets into Melchizedek. Now, I'd like to start, I want it, before I start into the outline, to tell you why I'm doing the study of Melchizedek. All men, or should I say all, have sinned. I've misinterpreted that paraphrase with the men. Forgive me, ladies, for doing that. But all men, excuse me, here I go again, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That's very true. That's Romans 3:23. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And that includes Melchizedek. Satan might use that as a weapon to keep you from solidly expressing what the Bible, the perfect Word of God, is saying from the source, the Word of God, Jesus Christ, from the coming from, of course, His source is the Father, by way of, and the Holy Spirit teaches us through Scripture. And don't ask me how to put an image of the three in the Godhead. It says so. That's as far as my human brain can go, as far as your human brain can go, because we're finite and He's infinite, okay? But God says, if any of you lack wisdom, this is in, now I'm talking about the King James and why you can understand it with the help of the Holy Spirit. It says, if any man, any of you lack wisdom, let him ask God, and that giveth to men, all men and women, liberally, and that's implied there, and it can be, and it's objective, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him, her. Now, in context, you should read James 1, 4 through 6, but my emphasis was on verse 5 there in James chapter 1. But just to be, want to look at the context, you go to verses 4 through 6 in James chapter 1. Okay. Now, that's good. How do you ask God to give you wisdom? Well, you ask, but it's, understand, it's faith. Having faith. And it says, and I'm emphasizing verse 38 of Hebrews 10, 37 through 39. It's the whole context of the passage, but still is valid by itself. Verse 38. How shall the just live by faith? Shall the just live by faith? But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. Who's saying that? God. He has no pleasure with anyone who doesn't walk by faith. Not blind faith. Holy Spirit gives you evidence along the way. And when you ask God's will in Jesus' name daily, you know, God's going to speak to you. He's going to work. He's the one that does all the work in the faith thing. You're just being willing to do it. And if something kind of discourages you, you can resist and submit to the Lord and know the Lord will make it go through. Here's an obstacle doing the faith, and I wanted to emphasize this. I didn't want to read it when I read James 5. James 1, 5 isn't James 1, 6. Let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavers like a wave of the sea driven with wind and tossed. Well, how do you do that? Ask God's will in Jesus' name, and you won't go wrong. God, greater is he that's in you than he is in the world. And I wish James hadn't said that, but people get on my case. Hey, that's the word of God. Well, yes, it is. It is, absolutely. Some people can get trapped in that. One of the examples of not doing faith today is I'm not perfect syndrome. This is a troubling thing. Well, we're not perfect, so why try? Why try? You see, and that I'm not perfect thing can be a dangerous thing if it's misused. See, and we don't want to do that. But remember, perfect person, God in your temple of your body will guide you into all truth, perfectly. And will cover the imperfections. You just pursue, okay? And that's why I didn't like James emphasizing the way he did there. It's kind of like Church of Jerusalem to me before the Antioch Church. It is still the perfect word of God. I mean, Satan's in the perfect word of God. Cast a stone to bread, you're going to do that? No. See? Context. That's what I'm trying to explain here. I had a guy on the radio who is upset. There's a guy going around saying, James didn't this and Peter this, and well, I've been doing that. I hope he's not referring to me, because I do believe that the Bible is the perfect word coming from the source Father through Jesus, the Word of God. Okay, don't say Pastor Lane said that he didn't believe that the Bible is not the perfect Word of God, because I do. Okay. I'm not, but I don't commit Bible adultery either, okay? Okay, now, here's another area of weakness. This Bible study on Melchizedek is one of many theories. This is done in Bible institutes and commentaries. See, it kind of weakens if any man lack wisdom, then come to me and I'll give liberally. Or a woman, come to me liberally, and I'll give liberally. Hello. I think there's a danger here. and I gotta end now. Go to part two.